fold it back on itself.
Kirby, there you are.
Oh, good. I don't have mine either. Here, look at this. This is the Thrasher book, so it's got like every cover. And then look at this shit. It's so good. So here's all theirs, and it's the only mag we ever missed. We were all fucked up on drugs that month. They missed an issue. Like, what if they missed an issue, like, nowadays, you know? Like, this is, luckily it's 82, they can get away with it. I made these with my dad. It's just two of them that kind of fit in like an L, but it's smooth as hell. Yeah, more photo books everywhere. Oh, look, there's an indie book. Okay, so Pedro said he wanted to go to this thing, which I made skatable, like, a while ago.
Oh, you take the fence down.
I cut the fence out and we zip tied it closed, so it's still skatable. Yep. Hey there, can I get two iced Americanos? Yeah, just two iced Americanos, black. Been in the van for 2 minutes and it's like a fucking, yeah, like we've been in here for 2 weeks.
I asked him about like a few dudes going on a trip, where the fuck they go.
He's bid on it.
Yeah.
But I don't think anyone's mad at that.
Pedro.
Check a couple more little hill bomb spots around here.
Yeah. White fence?
White fence. That's good. You know how to get to it?
Yeah.
I don't. Oh yeah, the gate's high as hell right there.
Dude, holy shit.
Are you surprised you did it?
Kinda.
I lowered that dot.
It's perfect.
Dude, this is gnarly shit.
Fuck you, dude.
Fuck you, dude.
I got lucky. I don't think people have been skating the spot too often. It's a little too heavy today.
One more
cut. We might have to thread the needle there. Holy shit.
We're fine.
I'm drinking fruit today.
I'm guessing we're just gonna come right here, right?
Olina Horn House, built in 1941. The city's trying to take it. They like to condemn classic historic properties and then rebuild McMansions like they did next door. The guy next door got that for $675,000 from, what's her name? She was like 92, lived in there with her cats. But yeah, this one is mortgage-free, been in the same family since 73. And Hollywood is trying to condemn, burn, destroy, just creeps Hollywood Division. And Garcetti's under investigation by the FBI, okay? So there's three lists, the condemnation or abatement list, then you look at the classic homes list, and then overlay those with the arson list, and then you're gonna see a pattern of how they're burning down classic homes and historics in Los Angeles. Look at the metadata, data about data. Start comparing and looking for patterns. How do these guys, Garcetti, become so rich? The guy in the Sony, here, Sony guy, he got a private road put in because he's friends with Garcetti, with no permits, it just, out of the blue.
You know a lot about skateboarding or?
Yeah, Tony Hawk. I don't know if Christian Asoy. I know Christian from way back. Welcome, come to the pool. Bring weed and beer.
That way or that way.
I'll take you out the gate.
All right, thank you.
Coming from poverty, hitting the lottery. Hottest commodity, the way that it had to be. Ain't no comparing me. You think of charity, I'm thinking integrity.
I'm gonna have to
all beer. Thank you. Thank you. Thinking vicariously, I'm in a space coupe.
dead momentarily. I've been dead, bro.
You can just like fold it back on itself.
There's like over there right there. What you got, bangs?
Really?
Yeah, you want a shot like hard clips?
Pedro, you got that shit?
Yeah. Oh, what a bail! That was so stupid.
Fuck, it was perfect.
I was gonna make it too, huh?
Yeah.
Yes!
Yeah.
Right here. Right fucking here. Fuck! So stupid. Saw that transition bailout? Alright, this curb sucks.
Yes, it does. You okay?
Yeah! I cleared it though. Had it.
Yeah, you did. Yeah. Wow.
Yeah. Alright, let's see if I can give another one. Kind of really tore my fucking. Woo! Oh yeah.
Yeah, Dro. Pedro knew what he wanted. And he fucking came here and conquered it with that fourth try. And we're sealing it back up. So you kids can't skate this. Just kidding, you can burn the shoelace and skate it. It's pretty easy to get here.
That one was overexposed.
See if we could wash some of this off. Oh.
How do you feel, Pedro?
Oh, I feel good. A little beat up, but we good. We good. Okay. A little shoulder check. Oh.
Damn.
Yeah. Don't bail, kids.
Handle
it's
it.
Not worth it. We made it. We made it. I'm stoked.
I wish you got first try, but.
It was there.
Those clips are fucking gold, though.
Your tranny slide?
Tranny slide.
The clean one?
And then the not clean one.
Shoot.
The Jake Brown one.
Have you ever tried to do the hand show?
I missed my foot.
Dude, wow.
Dangle the whole thing.
Oh.
Thank you. steamy beef.
Steamed ass beef. Thank you. Help me. All right, go, 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 go. Oh! Yeah. All right, go.
God.
You broke the whole thing. Look at the pivot.
Oh.
God, I need to lose a few pounds, eh?
Thank you.
another one real quick.
Oh!
tail.
Yeah!
like a couple days ago, finally put it together.
Yeah.
So you guys are probably just at his house.
Yeah.
So we work on shit, so we just put it together. Yeah, it's good.
Hell yeah.
It's all brand.
Thank you.
Fuck yeah. I got G's. Woo, banger.
Yeah. Kevin?
Thank you.
out.
That's so brutal.
They got napkins next to
me. Something
you walk
good.
Up to them like, hey, you got a fucking napkin.
Oh my god.
Someone give them this.
Give me something, dude. Come on. Oh, it's so long.
Somebody give it. Somebody on the ground.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Hey. Shit. Good axle. Good axle.
Yes!
Why does that keep happening? Sick, dude, I love hitting my head at every fucking part. Fuck! Send me fucking home!
Put that on your video. Yeah!
Sorry.
Thus we could diagram the source of the pain and that living. You.
Yeah, yeah, living. Yeah, exactly. You know, there were times when I was doing Jack that I actually felt.
We'll be right back.
God damn.
My God.
Thank you.
We're gonna do a little how to make a shitty curb skateable. This isn't really that bad of a curb, it just needs a little bit of work, but it's got a pretty epic scenic view with the ocean here. We got like, I don't know, 40, 50 foot drop on the other side. Yeah, it could be any curb in a parking lot or whatever, but this one I just eyed up and I was like, fuck, let's get this one going. So what we need today, we have brooms, can of Bondo to fix up the runway. We have cardboard to mix it on so you don't make a mess. Sandpaper or mob grip works good when you have some sheets. Applicator to spread it to make it smooth. We have rub brick, pretty unique tool for getting ledges, hubbies, and curbs going. It'll make a rough curb smoother. And then you apply concrete sealer. You paint it on, it's water-based. You have a cup and a brush, no cleanup really. Used this one the other day, didn't even clean it, and the brush is fine. It's like 30 bucks for a gallon, and that stuff will last. Then we have a mallet, just in case we gotta chip out any of the rough surface before we bondo it. All right, let's get it going. If you ever go skate with Salba, his philosophy is, instead of pushing the dirt, he's like, you pull it, it works better. I'll take his word up with this one. This just kind of gets rid of the roughness of the curb, make it a little smoother. And then, you know, once we put the concrete sealer on, it'll just be a lot faster. All right, you wanna get that half?
Gotcha, yeah. Number one thing, before you start lacquering and waxing, you wanna do a good job of getting all the dirt and sand off, because it'll mix in with the wax, get chunky, and then all the work you did was basically pointless, so.
Yep, keep it clean. The little seams are easy to fix. Just clean them out and then you can put Bondo in it. You won't even feel the crack. And a couple of these little chunks we might be able to fix. What up, dog? All right, it's a can of Bondo. Probably like 30 bucks at the auto parts store or hardware store. Great for fixing cracks on run up before rails and gaps or anywhere. It's a quick fix, pretty messy, but.
A good investment for any skater.
Yeah, gotta give a little bit in there. Comes with a hardener. It's reddish in color. It's like an activator. That will not dry by itself. So you need this to speed it up. It usually takes like 5 or 10 minutes to dry. Mix it up. You kinda sometimes gotta act quick if you put too much hardener in, because it'll dry up on you. So you're gonna take it over here to the curb. Just kinda apply it like that.
Oh yeah.
And you can make kind of a mess because it's just more work after sanding it, which is not a problem. Let that dry a little bit. You can use tape to tape it off, but this is kind of a quick fix, so no tape is needed.
Woo! Spraying.
I think we're tweaking over here. I've done like spray lacquer before, like, I don't know, random spots like hubbies and stuff or ledges, and people think you're actually spray painting.
Yeah,
you're tagging.
It kind of burns you out more.
Yeah, this is like, this stuff's pretty stealth. You just kind of like, with a paintbrush and this, and when you put it on, it's clear. So like, I've had the cops roll up to me like, hey, what are you doing? I'm just like, oh, I'm just putting this clear coat concrete sealer on this curb. And they're like, oh, interesting. Like, for what? And then you tell them, they're like, oh, that's cool then. All right, have a good day.
Yeah.
Kind of thing. So you haven't experienced
it
yet.
I haven't used this yet, so.
Yeah.
Do I just paint?
Yeah, just paint. It dries pretty quick, depending on like temperature and like the sun. Dude, there's no rhyme or reason.
Okay.
I mean, if you read the directions, it says like.
Like how thick do you like it?
Apply a coat like every hour and let it dry for like 72 hours, but it's like 5 minutes, it'll be good to go.
Does that look thick enough?
Yeah. Yeah, just keep it going, and then we'll let it dry, and then give it another coat. And people use the spray lacquer, but it's like you go through like cans, you know what I mean?
Oh yeah, right now it's like really windy outside, it would just blow away.
Oh yeah, for sure. This you can put it like on a roller too, you know, get it like a little paint roller.
Yeah.
Sun's coming out. You don't have this view at the skate park.
No, not at all. Yeah, it's drying over here finally.
Still pretty rough.
The sun's hitting it.
Solid.
It's dry. Some wax.
She's ready. She's ready for slides at least.
Cross off the back 50 because my board's gone down twice on it. It's just not worth it. We're gonna see a front hurricane if we have better luck with that. Take that. I don't feel like losing my board again.
Yeah, take it. Great spot. All right, curb. Shitty, everything else.
Terrible roll up.
Yeah, whatever.
I'm Eric Winkowski. These are my indies. Yeah, 159s. You said it. And yeah, they don't stick out. That's pretty much why. 169s is too big. I don't know the size, but two of those little ones.
How long you been riding indies for?
So long. I don't know. That's the hard, that's a hard question. I remember seeing other people, I remember seeing ride my board once, and he was like, damn, Indies are fucking sick. I forgot what he was riding, or something like that. He was like, damn, I gotta get some Indies again. Not like
them. Like in a groove?
Yeah, like in a groove.
See that groove?
My groove's kind of flat. There's not really that grooves I use. These have been going for maybe like 2 years now.
Damn.
I don't know. I'm not really thinking about changing them. Maybe might change the. Actually, I might put a new pair on just because I got my own truck, so I'm gonna probably rock some of those now. My favorite shit to grind, I'd say. Shit, concrete. Any type of concrete, it feels sick.
Favorite skate park?
The skate park.
Your backyard?
Yeah, back there.
What's it called?
Memorial.
That's fucking small.
Thank you.
And I made it this little cool song this morning that goes like this. Yeah, so, I don't know. I'd like to do a little guitar jam before we skate. Just get the vibe going. Get the lines going. I always feel that like lines on a guitar are almost lines like you skate. Here's the other thing too, and I always say this, that like, people don't look at skateboarders as artists. But every fucking skateboarder who's rad is making some art when they're doing their trip. That's what I think, you know what I mean? Yeah, so sorry guys, I gotta get my stretch on for a minute first before I do anything. I wanted a skateboard because number one, it made me feel good, you know? Number two, if I was having a bad day or whatever, or tired, when I could go to my skateboard and go put a smile on my face. And so there's that the whole mental aspect of that, you know what I mean? When I first got in Indy, was at the Winchester, no, it wasn't Winchester, it was the Newark contest. I actually saw Olson with a pair and saw him riding them. And wow, and I'd seen Blackheart at Pipeline raving about him. And then from there, at the contest, those guys came up to me and said, hey, also those guys are saying, you wanna try these trucks? And I go, hell yeah, I do, you know what I mean? But the fucking thing is, this is why I remember these trucks so much to this day. I'll never forget this, man. So at that point, I was really trying to do figure eight carves, right? But I couldn't quite finish the turn to go frontside figure eight. And the minute I put my Indies on, the fucking minute I fucking put them on, I could turn. And then I looked back up and I went frontside and just, oh dude, this just worked. So I was completely sold right there because they turned better and I can complete my figure eight carve backside to frontside. You know what I mean? That whole trip.
Oh wow, fucking A. That's amazing. Dude. Fuck yeah. That even looks like me crawling through the channel right there.
That 99.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem. I know you guys go,
yeah. And that's fucking so sick.
for his day in the life.
Yes, sir. Front front, tail grab.
Get the park.
So am I.
We're gonna make a little jump over the whole thing first.
Come around, check.
So sometimes we spend
doing that thing,
5 minutes, sometimes it takes 2 hours. But I think this is so fun to come do it again. It's been so long, you know what I mean?
Minute roll.
Yeah, all right, next one?
Yeah.
You guys ready?
Yeah.
We'll try to hit it out once a week.
Yeah. Yeah. Jake, push back. Push back.
Looks like they already opened the fence for us.
Oh, alright.
Lunch breaking. I liked Omar's
you know
when he was little because he did Brad fucking always to lip slide on the hip where me and Mickey did. I go, dude, that's fucking sick. I was super stoked. And then he did a lean to tail one day and I'm like, dude, you're fucking cool. You can hang with us any day.
But yeah, dude, it's been like, you know, years of being, you know, not only friend, fan, whatever. It's been like, you know, watching these dudes. We were just talking earlier about guys like Tony Alva. You get to an age. Saba's one of those people you strive to be at that age and still on your board ripping. So I mean, he's definitely an inspiration to all of our generation growing up.
Well, I like Omar, man. He's been my good buddy forever.
All right, let's
been my
now pucker
friend.
Up.
Yeah,
pucker up.
Gnarly. But anyhow, as kids, we just knew we didn't go down this alley. It was like it was no man's land, like your ass kicked or whatever. We saw these four kids, which were the older brother Gary being one of them, and these other kids. Lee Geheimer, who became one of my mentors later, jump over this fence, like four or five houses down from the main street we were on. Then we couldn't see him, but we could hear him. And we could hear the skateboard sound of that swooshy sound when you skate a pool. You could hear the boards falling, tumbling down the wall. But we still didn't put two and two together yet. We didn't know they were skateboarding in the pool. We just, well, what are they doing? And then they split. When they left, we went in and to check it all out. And I'm going like, dude, those guys are skating in that pool. Like, wow, how do you even do that? You know what I mean? First off, one guy started at the top in the shallow end and tried to ride a deep end. And by the time he hit the deep end, hit the wall, he just went flying. Did like a flip, almost killed himself, and we were all laughing, ha ha ha. But then, like, you know, we're thinking, God, that was kind of gnarly. Maybe we shouldn't start the shallow end. So we kind of just started kind of down there by the drain and just kind of tic-tacking around the drain at first. I mean, the first time when I first started skating, I was 10. So I probably skated that pool within the first 9 months of me skateboarding. So I probably rode that pool like late 74, 75. Probably 75, to be honest with you. And at that point, I figured, like, dude, I like this pool riding thing so much, I want to be like a bull rider, pool rider. And then plus you saw stuff in Skateboarder magazine that kind of like, they were doing it too, and then it gave me like, you know, if these guys are doing it, I can do it kind of thing, you know what I mean?
I want their home because their mail's out and their newspaper. Well, if anything, we gotta wait for those guys to get here anyway before we make a decision what to do, so I guess we just have to wait. Yeah, cause I tried to call her earlier too, but she didn't answer when I tried to call either. Damn, I really wanted to skate this pool too. This pool's really good. Damn, I wish she'd answer the door. I gotta say, usually too, we come in the morning. We don't usually come this late. I wonder, like, a store or shopping or something, maybe too, you know what I mean? That's the kind of thing about skating pools and skating street. There's always an adventure, there's always a story about it. When you're in this shit and in the street, it's just a little more real, you know what I mean? And when it's a little more real, when you actually make that shit, it just means a lot much more to you, you know what I mean? And I don't think a lot of the fucking the older kind of guys see the parallel of that. I mean, the street skating guys are having to trespass like we are. They're having to constantly fix things, you know, patch things and do stuff like that. And sometimes they're trying to take water out and they're always getting caught, hassled by the cops or hassled by the neighbors or hassled by somebody. So it's the same shit, man. Someone like Milton Martinez is a mind-blowing guy. I don't really know the guy, I never met him yet, but I like what he does. He's amazing, man. And so there's certain guys that you see, you know, just like, well, dude, I want to see that. I want to meet that guy, you know what I mean? Yeah, you know, man, I don't think they're home. So I don't know if we can skate here. I don't know where else we can go, because I only drained a couple things. We'd have to go back to Rialto at this point.
How about that skate. Square pool? Probably water?
It probably has water. I mean, you guys got a generator?
Cold these, yeah.
Ooh, I got the fucking pumps.
Yeah.
Bam! Oh, that's a lot of water, though, dude. But with the generator and the pump, we could probably bust at it.
City pool or something?
This pool's not the best pool to skate, but it's fun.
Fucking reeks.
Drain cover.
Oh yeah.
Cord go in the white bucket.
So that's the cool thing. I usually just start here because it's gnarly and go to the other ones.
Top five guitar players?
Yeah, who's your top five guitar players?
Well, Poison Ivy. She's number one by far. She's by far the favorite guitarist I've ever seen. I've seen the cramps so many times, and just the fact that she was a girl playing in those days was fucking spectacular in my book, because that was a male-dominated punk rock world, and here's this chick styling, out rocking them all in my book, and she was a good guitar player too, so he's no slouch. After that, I have to say Setzer, because he's a monster, not even the Stray Cats, but just all the shit he can do, people don't even know. That's three, him, Billy Zoom. The other guy I'm gonna say is, I really like Johnny Thunders a lot. My other dude's probably the guy from Dead Kennedys, man. I just love that kind of stuff and just the echo. That's actually what this one right here. So that kind of stuff, you know what I mean? And it was kind of like half surf, half punk. Now the funny thing is, I got a guitar for my 18th birthday. That's when I started to play guitar. And to be honest with you, playing guitar at 18 is really late. That's like a late bloomer, big time. And when I started really learning how to play guitar, the first dudes who started showing me stuff were showing me Surf, just for the melodies and pipeline and the kind of chords for that. I mean, it's even like, you know, you can ride away with pipeline, oh, ooh, you're having a little success, man. Like, ooh, this sounds cool, you know what I mean? Wow, you know, so that kind of stuff. And then shortly thereafter that, you kind of get in all the punk. And then from the punk, you just get in all your different little fucking trips, whether it's the English guys, and whether it's the New York guys, or whether it's the Detroit guys, or whether it's the LA guys, you know what I mean? Where's that come from? I never heard that. That's fucking awesome, Mike. Then you find out that's another American dude who went to England in 58 because he couldn't make it here, and he became a star in England, Vince Taylor. And he was fucking huge, you know, over in England. The first band I was in was like a kind of psychobilly, rockabilly kind of trip. And then the Flamethrowers were like kind of just played all that kind of crazy, like this shit. In my opinion, the Flamethrowers were fucking rad, though. It was like, almost like a half cross between punk and almost like Motorhead kind of shit. Our drummer used to take speed all the time. So he was just like, blah, 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 blah. Just fucking total fucking crazy Motorhead shit. You know what I mean? That was this dude, fucking Filthy fucking Ned and all the fucking dudes. And you know what I mean? So he was super into that shit. So he was super fucking good, man. From there, we made another band, 10,000 Heartaches, and then fucking the Dirty Bastards, fucking all kinds of shit. And then we ended up making Powerflex with Corey Miller. And so we've been doing that for, geez, almost probably 20 years at this point. I got a song. We do a song, Skate and Destroy, because I wanted a top cab Skate and Destroy. There's, in my opinion, there's all these Skate and Destroys, yeah. But I think our fucking version is sick. We have another song called, it's about breaking your wrist. Oh, dude, fuck, how's it go again? It says, Anyhow, yeah, it's a fucking rad song. So that's on there. There's like more punk this time than surf. Like on purpose. I go, come on, dude, we gotta get fucking rad again, you know? Fuck, whatever, I mean.
Yeah, I mean, anything will work. You know what I mean?
Let's make whatever. So, Thank you. How about, what was that one I was doing the other day? Oh. I just made this up like 4 nights ago. I go, that sounds kind of cool.
So it's got two right there.
Well, Ray Barbie is no fucking slouch. Chuck Treese is another guy that's a fucking monster. He's like one of my favorite dudes I've ever jammed with. Ron Emery, he's another guy. David Gonzalez. Dude, there's a lot of dudes who fucking skate that play. So there's all kinds. Even Monk was fucking rad. You know what I mean? And the funny thing is a lot of people think because they did that song about Salva Sauce that they were fucking trying to diss me. And on one hand, he might have been. But the thing is, when they fucking made that song, they were fucking drunk as a skunk. They called me at like midnight. Dude, this is a song I was fucking made, Salva Sauce. And him and the fucking dudes were fucking singing over the phone and playing on acoustics. Dude, that is so fucking bitching. Those guys are fucking cool, man. I like that, that they just put everything in their truck and just set up shop and bam. It's like fucking Road Warrior shit, dude. You know what I mean? I'm thinking right now in my book, my favorite pool dude is Tristan. Or Jay Worth It. I think they're both fucking sick in their own right. And they both are fucking crazy. But then you got fucking Jesse fucking Beanwater, man. That motherfucker's whap. That guy's fucking amazing. And then you got Chris Cope, switch fucking stair set. And then there ain't fucking no denying about Peter fucking Hewitt. Top five pools ever.
Ever.
Ever. You know, Colossus. Jeez. Dolphin pool. And I didn't skate there that good, but I'm gonna put fucking that San Diego fucking pool at the fucking hotel. What was that one called? El Cortez. That thing was fucking sick. Dude, Norwalk. Yep. Norwalk is definitely in there. And then, God, that leaves a hard, hard last one here, man, because there's a lot of fucking crazy ones. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to say sick in Van Ness Roman. That thing was fucking ludicrous, because not only did it have the Roman in deep end, it had shallow stairs. And not only did it have shallow stairs, the pocket Roman in the shallow allowed you to do shallow stairs, but allowed you to do a grind here or a grind here next to it. And it was so good. Some of the dudes were doing fakey rocks and shit off that and popping off the Roman to the sidewall. I mean, fuck, you skate that thing. That thing was fucking insane. Top five pipes. You've been to a lot of them with me, man. So I'm going to say, in my opinion, all the shit I've ever skated, Amarillo's by far the raddest one. But it's maybe not as technically smooth as Sugarloaf. Or even, well, I'm not even gonna go with that one. Baldy's definitely in there. Baldy's not the best, but it's the first. It's still there. It's where I grew up, and it has to be in that top five. Okay, now we're not even forgetting about CAP and Amarillo and Amaron. So those are by far the best pipes. So yeah, I'd have to reverse that order. It's gonna go Amaron, CAP first, all the Arizona shit. So I'm thinking those are number one, number two for sure. And then Amarillo, three, and then Silverjack, and then Baldy. But there's a couple others that are probably just as rad in their own right. And there's one that's super, super sick, but I'm not gonna give that to you right now. I'm gonna go skate that one again first. I'm just trying to think what kind of heavy one I like. Nah, that ain't gonna work. Yeah, Powerflex 3. Okay, I could do one of those, so I can go see that goes up. Mm-hmm.
Good right here.
Good.
All right, should I put the guitar away now or what?
Yeah.
These are a lot of my stencils right here. So these are the kind of things that make something like this. I was super fucking hyped. Because I actually got to do some artwork for Santa Cruz that they put on a board. I was kind of gassed on this one because this kind of almost reminded me of almost, not exactly a screaming hand, but this is like from an old pull sign. I always wondered if Phillips kind of got the screaming hand from a fucking pull sign maybe, because that kind of pull stuff is kind of cool, the aesthetic of it. Now some of these things I call my pull aesthetics, and like these are more like diving kind of things, as opposed to like pull things more like this, you know what I mean? Which is almost like a Blue Haven logo, but it's not exactly a Blue Haven logo. I kind of redid it. And then like say stuff like this, the stencil, I always cut all these by hand. But it's just, I take different ideas from, I'll say like for this, you know, that was like an old pool thing from England. I just cut a couple pieces out of it. Most graphic artists kind of like use different things and take them out of context and put them in a new context, so to speak. So that's the kind of a lot of this shit is, you know, like this is actually from a pool sign. And then the cool thing about when you start doing this shit, you start learning how to layer it. You know, usually I do these in two colors, like white and blue. Here's the white of the other chick, right? And when you start like hand cutting out, I mean, that's a lot of work that fucking goes into these things, you know what I mean? Because this whole box is filled with hours and hours and hours of me cutting this shit. You know what I mean? Let's see what else I got in here. Like every Halloween, I do stuff like Frankenstein stuff and Dracula and Lily Munster and all kind of Frank, you know, Halloween. So that's kind of like a Halloween one. That's what I try to do, to be honest with you, is kind of invite you to Salba World, kind of, so to speak. You know what I mean? I was in Ohio with Roscop back in like 89. And this kid was wearing a shirt and we were signing autographs in line. I'm like, dude, that's me. That's from Nude Bowl. Where'd you get that shirt at? And he didn't remember. And his dad, I'm like, dude, dad, like, that's me. You gotta give me that shirt somehow. And the little kid wasn't having it. And I'm like, dude, I'll give you my board. That's that. I go, dude, I'll give you my board and $100. So that's what I did. I just found this shirt just 2 days ago. But I mean, I've had it since 89. It's kind of rad. So that's the thing in here. I got so much crazy random shit on one hand. It is kind of museum-ish on one hand. Everything's got like a story behind it. Anyhow, shadow boxes. This was one of my first ones I actually built. Like, as far as like the bigger shadow boxes. And this chick, this image, I've kind of used her a lot through the years, like from a pool sign. Now, generally make the shadow boxes, I tried to put found items from the pool I skated from where I got the shadow box. This was more like personalized for me because I always wear my wrist brace and my glove. There's an old indie. Some of my Spitfires, you know, some Badlands stickers, like an old beer can from the pool, like some cigarettes we found in the pool, you know what I mean, that kind of trip. This is like a bigger one I made for an art show. It's got my old camera from shooting photos of pools. It's got pool dust. And here's the drain from the pool. Some like a thing from the house, and the Pele Grosso, like don't go in the house. That's the broken Indy from that same pool I rode. That's the broken light. So like I say, each shadow box has like a lot of personal things from the pool I find. But then it has like a little bit of shit like my board, my wheels, my fucking glove, the kind of shit I'm known for, you know what I mean? Like that's why this one's the same thing. I always try to keep like an even color scheme. It all happened because the sign was originally, it was the fucking for sale sign out front. And we didn't have anything to fucking use the shovel to get the shit out of the pool. So I went out fucking front, knocked the pool sign off, and all of a sudden we got like a shovel to get the shit out, right? And I'm going, fuck, I'm going to take this thing home and make some rat art out of it. My little kid Riley would always take my old boards I would ride and then ride them in the street. And him and Jesse would always have one of my pool boards for their cruiser boards. And they put softies on it, and that's what they'd ride all over the place. So he actually rode that board after I rode it, which was sick. And then I actually got it back from him and then put the, you know, little girl on it from that other thing. There was a church right around the corner from there having a rummage sale. And I stopped and I go, dude, those letters, I want those letters. So I've used those for the fucking art project. I found his ass somewhere. You know, for Steve. Well, remember the pool in Garden Grove, Orange Bowl?
Yeah.
That one where Omar, or that one dude went up down the slide, whap! Yeah. That's the fiberglass from that pool. A couple stencils I put in there too. So yeah, I mean, Johnny Thunder's another stencil with like the same letters right here. This is the first Alba board ever right here.
that had my name on it. But I couldn't accept it. I didn't want to ride it. I told him, dude, like, I can't ride that. I'll fucking break it. So I go, dude, make me a wood board. And then they go, okay. And that's when they made that little beam me up thing. The raddest K-beam is this one right here. That one's good too. But this right here, this is the fucking Kryptonic board. I used to ride this board in high school. And so when I got hurt and tore my ACL at the Winchester contest, I couldn't skate for a while. When I got a little bit better, all I would do was ride this from my house to my girlfriend Vicky's house. And she's the girl in that little skateboarder shit with the dark hair. Anyhow, I gave this to her and I broke up with her. And then one day I was going to Martin's Pool, which is a block away. And I'm driving by Vicky's house and her mom's outside. And I, oh shit, she's her mom's outside. And I stop and I go, hey, Mrs. Gamble. And I get out of my car, I take Jesse out. And I go, hey, I don't know if you remember me. And I used to date your daughter in high school. My name's Steve Alba. Oh yeah, you're the punk rock skateboarder boy. How you doing? Yeah, blah, 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 blah. And I was like, so hey, I don't know how to ask you this, but my boy doesn't believe I have a skateboard with my name on it. And I was really hoping that board I left at your house, that you guys still have it. And she's off, you know what, Steve, you're not gonna believe it. It's still in the same place you left it 20 some years ago. And I'm all, you kidding me? And she's all, you know what? Vicky's on her way over here right now. I can't give it to you, but you can talk to her about it. And then my wheel started spinning in my head. I started scheming. I went home, I put a whole new setup together, a little board for a little dude, because I knew she had a little dude my kid's age. I go back to her house, I see her, and I say, hey, how's it going? How's it going? Blah, blah, blah. Give her a hug, blah, 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 blah. How's it going? I haven't seen you. Oh, hey, by the way, my boy right here, Jesse, doesn't believe I have a skateboard with my name on it. Do you still have that skateboard? Oh, yeah, I do. It's in the closet. You want it back? That would be so amazingly wonderful. Would you please give it back? Of course. Well, can you get my little boy skateboard? Of course. I'm going back in my car, boom, and have the board, and then she gives it back to me. Dude, this board fucking sat in her closet since I was 18 years old, 17 years old, 17 years old, until what? I had Jesse in 93, so he's probably about, I'm thinking I probably got this back in 97, 98. Yeah, so some of these boards I still kind of like, yeah, I bust them out, make people ride them here and there, you know what I mean? Fuck. Look at this shit, dude. Straight up rad tiger shit. Custom radness from the old days. Yeah.
We gotta wrap it up.
Yeah, well, that's a sick one, too. Sick. So they got the original bushings. I'm thinking these are stage, I think these are stage two or stage threes. You can always tell by the square here. Whoa. A little square, and then down the pivot cup goes kind of round down here. And these, like where the pivot cup is, they always have these little nipple things that kind of stuck up on the first two or three of them. You want some jazzy kind of shit? Yeah. Okay, here you go.
Yeah, that sounds pretty cool. Cool.
Good enough for the fucking recording?
I like this part here.
Now it's not the end.
Oh, dude. God, sickle. You all right?
I heard you going, oh, before
I even was falling. That was awesome. Ah, box me, baby. Fuck you. Yeah. Right, dude? That shit was sick, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
10
o'clock Sunday morning.
Crazy at a project.
You have to.
I don't think anyone has ever seen me as crazy as I would go at a project concert.
How about you guys? I'm
fired.
Shit. Are you about the old man? Sick.
Dude, he's hot. He's pretty hot up there, man. That's cool.
Death box.
Face when you come to Salvaland, and it got to be more than 2 days because there's so much stuff to skate. Sometimes you get shut down. You got to get all the boys involved. Today we got Winco and Tristan, Bunk, Dressin and Bennett, and Lance Mountain, and myself, and Art and Rhino and all the boys. Can't be all about me. That's boring. So we get everybody involved, and it makes it even funner and radder, and we all have a great time. Thank you, Indy, all the way. Boom.
Hi, this is Eric Dressin, and these are my indies.
probably 79, looking at skateboarder magazines, seeing photos of like Dwayne and like Steve Olsen riding indies, and like Scott Frost. I remember him showing up at Marina Skate Park, and he just had indie stickers all over his helmet, and I was just like, oh, that's the sickest thing. I want to ride for Indy. I'm a kid in the 70s, just watching like Tony Alva and Jams, all the gnarly dudes just carb grinding and skating as fast as they can, so that's how I want to skate too. And I think I got my first pair of indies in the parking lot of Big O. It was like during a Big O contest. I'm not sure who gave them to me, but Dwayne said something to somebody like, give this kid some indies. And I switched out my trucks, but I've always rode indies ever since. My setups, I always ride Santa Cruz boards, independent trucks, independent hardware, and OJ wheels, the Elite Formula. I like to ride 56 millimeter, and I like the 101 hardness. And then I just started riding the Bronson ceramic bearings, and they're insane. I rode every bearing there is, and these are the fastest and smoothest. I like riding the 159s, standard, because I ride a 9-inch wide board, and they fit just perfect. They don't hang over, they just ride on the edge right there. I like to ride the independent, genuine parts white bushings, the soft ones. These ones just are perfect. Right when you put them on, they're just good to go, and they last forever. And I also like to use indie bolts. These things are sick. My last two pairs of indies I had for 4 years. Somehow I just never changed them. I had one pair of 149s that I rode for almost 5 years solid. They were just grind down perfect and just turned perfect. And then I started riding wider boards, so I started riding the 159s. And I rode those, my last pair of trucks, for at least 3 years. But then I'd been saving these black anodized ones for a while. I was waiting for like the special board. So when I got this, my new board in the black stain, I was like, oh, that'll go perfect. Like, I just love how the black trucks look on this black board. I just think it looks so tough. And it reminds me of like the late 80s Santa Cruz setups and stuff. It looks like some truck like Grosso or Tom Knox would ride these, you know, and like the old sick photos of those guys. Yeah, I'm just so proud to be part of the independent legacy. I was just a fan, and just, you know, as a kid, you dream about being on teams, and like, I'm on Indy, and I still trip to this day because Indy's the sickest, and it's part of our culture. It's been a tradition, and all my favorite skaters ride Indies. From back in the day, Brad Bowman rode Indies. Like, his boards look so sick, his setups with his Indies, and Salba, Malba. Olsen board back in the old Santa Cruz board back in the day with Indies, that was the sickest setup you could have. I'm just obsessed with skateboards. Like, I love every part of it, like grip tape. And like, say these trucks, I sat and looked at them for 2 years, waiting to ride them. They look so rad. Just looking at them looked so tough, and just wanted them on the perfect board. And then nowadays, like Milton Martinez rides Indies. His trucks are sick. Like, you know, I just look at it, I want his truck. Or even Hewitt, you know, they're like living, breathing tradition of Indy. You know, they just live and breathe it. It's so sick. And I want to be like that too.
Christmas Eve, too. Change your life when the sun fits you.
That's fucking wild.
Thank you. I don't want the any money, but I'm broke, so
thank you.
Thank you.
My dad.
Okay. Attention, attention.
C'est bon, c'est bon. C'est lui.
Yeah.
J'ai même pas vu. À refaire.
Ah, t'as vu, il a réussi. Il est fort, hein.